So, welcome back, and it's time for episode 68 of Series 3 of Orion, and here we are. Like I said, I was going to do a Christmas episode. So anyways, Merry Christmas from me. Hope you guys had a good Christmas. And now I'm ready to do this episode. And I know you're probably wondering what I'm wearing since I got this. I'm actually going to step over here so I can show it a little more easily. It's kind of like a, I don't know if I should say exactly complete tracksuit outfit like the other thing I wore with the pullover shirt and those pants. But I didn't actually get this today, like on Christmas. It wasn't a present. It was some actually bought yesterday for myself. So yeah, just wanted to show it. It's actually a really cozy little thing too. Let me step in the light. Yeah, I could somewhat see it in that light. I really don't want to get my dogs barking with that light, so. Coming on, so yeah, I'm just showing it. Okay, fine, actually I will. Yeah, now you can see it more easily. See it? Yeah, Jack goes down like this far in length, but pick it up a bit to show some of the pants. So yeah. And down view, so anyways. There we go, showed it. Now let's get on to the episode. And it says I have 34 minutes of recording things, so I don't want to make this too long. So anyways, and there's a little thing down here, so that's why I'm not exactly completely up against the counter. Let's see, and I got a leg on top of it. That's the best way I can do it, kind of while facing this way. So anyways, well, here we are in kind of in the kitchen again. Actually, not really. I mean, it is kind of somewhat connected in the kitchen, but it's not in that area over there. That is actually inside the kitchen, like episodes 65 and 66 were. And 67 was up there, and 68 is here. So anyways, so let's get on with this. And it's a very special one, I see, because it's Christmas time. Really, you like Christmas? Of course I do. Even separate bad men love Christmas. At times. And hell, I love it. No matter how much of a man I am like that, of an evil guy to you guys like that and all, but I still love Christmas. Well, I guess that's a good thing. We can have that in common. You're actually right. But let's get ready for this battle. And let's see who wins the special Christmas battle in a Christmas episode. It'll be a Merry Christmas to all. So who's going to lead against me? And I swear to God, if it lands on Robert, oh, it landed on 8, so it is going to be Pete. Pete's leading. Oh, finally, a change in leader of leading against me. It's not Robert this time. After 3 in a row, Pete's leading this time. So here we go. Maybe we should have a change. Okay, and from the last episode results, I'm trying to remember who won last. Sid 166. I believe, crap, I should have looked back at the last one, at 67 to see who won that one. I know they won 65, he won 66, actually, no way, I remember doing stuff of saying, I'm going to get 2 wins in a row. I think I remember saying that last time. I think he did get it, because yeah, I remember now, because I remember doing a part where he's like, 2 in a row, baby. That I remember doing that. So, yep. So, yeah, I'm going to say he's at 2 wins in a row, but I'll have to look back at the last one. But right now, I'll just say he's at 2, unless it's different. But if it is that much, then I was right. So, he's going for 3 in a row. And I remember saying his actual longest win streak in Series 2 was actually around 6 or 5. He was saying 8 or 9 to match theirs. So, yeah, he's going to try and beat his own and then get up to theirs and try and have the longest win streak ever done in Army Men if he gets at least to 9 or 10. Alright, but anyways, let's get on with it. So Pete's leading against me and the Christmas battle is underway. Who's going to win and have a Merry Christmas? Oh, we have a regular double to start this one. Oh, triple maybe. Jeez. Four times? Holy shit, we're already starting off with huge numbers. Ah, damn it. It's four times, though. Four and four, that's 16. No, that ain't gonna do anything. I only have 12. If that landed on three, that would have been all of them. Dang it. So no damage done. Damn it. Two men. Two men already down. I'm gonna take you to the money pit. Oh, I won that one. We could have this one closer. Four men. There we go. Four men. Once I clear out some of these men around here, then it'll be easier. I won that one too. Three of them. I'll try and find ways to include Nick in this, because I really want to include Nick into more. Since he's the main guy in the arc, we need to have some Genocider Nick on Christmas. Five of them. No. Well, Jesus, look how this is going. You're already down to that much. Oh, double. Oh, it only went up to double this time and they won it. Three, that's six. I'm down to four men. Jesus. How's that feel, Sid? Pete, what the hell? Hey, I'm the leader of this battle against you. Well, yeah, but still, what do you have to say? Basically, you're not doing too well. Really, that's all you gotta say? Guess as long as it wasn't too harsh. And now I'm back to winning dice rolls, and let's take out four men. Yeah, it's my cue to kill them all. Kill these bitches. Better not get that four, Pete. You missed too, but still, you want to end up doing that? I'm going to turn this area to a bloodbath, and I'll make sure you taste it. What are you stealing my thing for? From episode 66. Oh, the whole bloodbath and I'm going to make sure you taste it thing? That's become a catchphrase now, apparently. Yeah, even off camera, I just keep saying that phrase a lot for some reason. Like, off camera, I just say that. I might even end up putting that into some of the recaps. Like, it's a thing now to say we're going to make these areas bloodbaths, and we're going to make sure that we taste them. Oh, another regular double. Oh, triple. Ah! The only thing they can get is a one to take out three men. Oh, he got it, too. Damn it! And you actually did get it. Now I'm down to one guy. Come on, briefcase guy. Kill him for me. Kill for me. Kill for me. Oh, I want a low number reversal. There we go. And six men. Yes! Oh, this is going to be a big Christmas present for me to have three wins in a row. It's definitely something to be worthy about. Or you're going to end up losing and you're going to become a Scrooge. Oh, please. Even if I lose, I'm not going to become Ebenezer Scrooge. I'm not like him. I'll still love Christmas no matter what. I'll still love Christmas no matter what, Pete. So your words isn't going to do a damn thing to me about changing my thoughts on Christmas. Even if you beat me and you end my streak, I'll be pissed. But that won't make me hate Christmas. If that's what you guys are trying to do, get me to hate Christmas, that ain't happening. It's going to be even better for me, actually, because I'm going to win. Yeah, like you will. You only got one guy. But we still have HP battle. Have you forgotten that? No. Then why didn't you say anything about it? Hey, why don't you stop before I have to unleash again? Oh, really, Nick? You and your genocider persona. Seriously, what the hell is he going to do? Why would he want to attack on Christmas? Because, you know, there could be killers around. Ever seen Silent Night, Deadly Night, Sid? What the hell are you talking about? Those films. And yeah, I actually have heard of those films and the little scenes in them. Especially that Rampage scene in the second film. I've seen the clips of that one, but I haven't seen the entire movie. And the whole Garbage Day thing that everybody's parodied or made a meme of. God damn it, you better not get the one, or else it's gonna be Garbage Day for you. Dang it, Patch is not the gate over. And if you want to get that one, I'm going to make sure it's going to be Garbage Day here. And a bloodbath. And I'll make sure you taste it. You and Nick. What the hell did I do? You know what you did, Nick. You came in with your little snide replies about unleashing your genocider persona on Christmas. Oh, that was close, but you missed. There goes two men. You're down to the last line. Down to the wire. It's not exactly down to the wire unless it's very, very close. Maybe say when we have two guys left. Or maybe even three. And definitely one. Then we'll say that. Well, it's about to get to that. Two men. Yeah. But keep racking up a few twos and we can have a shot. Oh, six men left. You're gonna lose, Pete. I'm gonna beat you. Two again. Actually, keep doing that because I'll keep getting two to take them all out. Oh. Yes, I'm going to get it. It's going to keep giving me two, so that means I'm going to take out these men once I win another dice roll. Nope. Well, you're not going to get the one. See? You didn't get it. Now, here we go. I'm about to get that two. Told ya, bitch! Well, looks like your first 10 or HP battle again, so it seems like you guys have been struggling lately because I've gotten to two, about to be three wins in a row. And I haven't hit that much this series. So, is it only you coming in, Pete, or is Joe coming with you? It's only Pete. Geez, the last few HP battles we've had in episodes have only been the main guy. The backing guy hasn't joined. Oh, so it's only you, Pete. So that means only I go. Jesus, Jack hasn't been in with me in some time in these HP battles, and neither have any of you guys as backing guys. Maybe you should rather let me get down to HP first, so I can still try and win, because then I can actually manage to get Jack in there. It's happened before when we enter it first. Yeah, but not too commonly. Anyways, I'm going to use my first guard check. Yeah, I saved them up. So I have a chance of winning at least one of them, if not all. Oh, and I won that one too. So you're already taking double damage. Six, that's 12. You're down to 18 already. How sad. You want to talk sad? Come over here, I'll sock you in your face. Oh, you want to fight on Christmas? We'll brawl? Bring it on then. Yeah, and you just had your guy knocked over by slamming down the dice, Sid. I don't care, I'll pick him up. Whatever, Sid, that little bitch is going down anyway. You touch him, you're dead. I don't mean exactly that. We'll get the dice roll and kill him. That's what I meant. Dumbass. Don't call me that. I knew what you meant. Then why didn't you agree with it? Because I was playing on you. Psychological mind games, remember? How the hell do you know that crap? Because I do. There are things I know, so don't try and keep calling me stupid all the time when I actually do know things. In fact, there might be things that you guys don't know. Well, okay, maybe you're right. But still, how the hell do you even know about it? I just do. Now roll the dice. compete and get ready to lose. Now you're at 13. Oh, watch. I'm about to get this one right here and kill that guy. You better not. If you get that one, I'm going to jump you right now and we're going to fight. And you missed. So how does it feel? Oh, I got him. You son of a bitch. You're going to get it. Hey, knock it off. Excuse me, Nick's about to turn the genocide to Nick, so I better get the knife for it. Yep. Weapons and psychotic behavior, even on Christmas. Oh shit, he fell, hold on. You're not eating him. That's enough! I told you, if I had to hear any more of this random bickering crap for no reason, I will unleash on you. You understand? You said it was between me and Robert! But you're still involved. What? You didn't say for me and anybody else. You said just for me and Robert. Well, now it's for everybody else. You sick son of a bitch. Change up the rules? Hey, I can make up what rules I want. You got a problem with that? Then get out. You're going to forfeit and you're going to lose. I'm not giving up. So you can just put that damn knife away and let us continue fighting. Now go back in your spot. I'll go. But you want to keep talking to me like that? I'll stab you to death right now. I don't care if it's Christmas. I will still draw some blood on Christmas. That will be my present. Blood on a plate to drink. And your bodily remains to put on my shelf. So eat it, bitch. Okay then, Jesus. Guy's fucking psycho. Let's continue our HP battle, though. You haven't taken damage yet. Yeah, you're actually right, Pete. But you're down to 13 still. And I'm gonna use my first guard check. Ah, and you won it. 4, that's 8. I'm at 22. Oh, a regular double. And they're both down to 2 guard checks. Oh, triple. Oh, Pete won it. And Sid's at 22, so he's going to take plenty of damage in a triple. Oh, one, that's 3. I'm at 19. Oh, another double. Oh, and I got that one. Alright, Sid's at 19, Pete's at 13, and it's a double. So if it goes up to a 6, Pete's gonna go all the way down to 1. Oh, and it did. 6, that's 12, and you're at 13, so you're down to 1. And I'm still at 19. So I'm gonna win. You probably just jinxed yourself. No, I didn't. I'll prove you wrong once I get that 1. Nope, you're not gonna get it here. You got it on that roll, but not the killing roll. Whatever. How much is it going to be? Now I'm at 14. Now I'm going to use my second guard check. Alright, Sid can't really use any since Pete's at 1. You're really going to use it there? Well, you are at 14. Or it could be tripled if he wins it. Oh, you son of a bitch. You just had to guess it correctly. Well, it's not going to drain all of it, even if you get a 6. And it's a triple, actually. Actually, if it lands on a 6 triple, I'm at 14, ain't going to do anything. Same with a 5, it'll be at 15. And you're probably going to get one of those two numbers. Ha, told you. So that was all just a waste. I still have one left. Yeah. Probably best not to embarrass yourself and waste it. See, that's kind of helpful. Okay, we can't do a regular double because Pete's at one. Damn it. Now I'm at 11. Seven. Oh, here we go. I'm about to get the one. I get the one here. It's game over for you. Yeah, and if you get it, I'm going to kick your ass. Oh, we already brawled once, so why not do it again? I'm going to get that one. No, you're not. Ha, you missed. Oh, I still got a shot. Don't worry. Can't do a regular double. Now I'm at five. I'm in the range. Here we go. I'm going to get that one. You better not. What are you doing with his knife? How about I'll do the honors for Nick? And slice you into pieces. Because you're testing my patience for the last time. Now roll it, Sid. Damn it! Missed again! Oh, I got another shot. Here we go. I'm gonna get it. No, you're not. I told you I'd get it, bitch. Three in a row. That's it. That's it. You know the rules. You lost. Get the fuck out of here. Hey, don't kick me. Oh, you want to do that? Let's take it to the floor. On the bed. I told them, and they wouldn't listen. Wait, Nick, stop. That's enough. I told you, you'd keep doing it, I'd attack. Nick, seriously, it's not what it looks like. Get out of here. You kicked him in the face. I might as well spare Pete, since he didn't start this one. No, you're not killing me. You gotta deal with the rules, so you're at least gonna get a mark. I'm not gonna kill you, but you're gonna get a mark. Now hold still. Jesus, that's more than a mark. I hope you learned your lesson, bitch. You don't mess with my friends. Remember, like I'll tell you again, Sid, messing with my friends is asking for a death wish. You got that? Okay, yes, just go. Good. I hope you understand that. Because if you do it again, I will kill you. And I'll eat you up. Vore you alive. And then there'll be nothing left of you as soon as you're digested. You're a sick cannibal, you know that, right? I don't care what you call me. I may be a sick dude, I may have screws loose, but I still know stuff. Believe me, there are things I still know about preserving and what kind of things to plan out for my behavior and me to come out while Nick sits in the back. So yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I do have screws loose. But I still know what to do. So remember that, Sid. hope you're happy, Sid. Go celebrate your victory. Whatever, just get out of here, Pete. I don't want to look at you right now. I don't want to look at you either. We'll do something about him. Still a Merry Christmas, though, for us, because we won 3 in a row. That's my big Christmas present. So there we go. He will pay for what he did, Pete. He surely will. He's gonna pay. Alright, let me put this up so I can get a good proper Christmas ending. Well, that concludes the episode. Our Christmas episode is complete. And again, Merry Christmas, everyone. Hope you all have had a nice Christmas. Army men, say it too. Merry Christmas, everyone. Now, come on, Sid and Jack. Fine. Merry Christmas, everyone. Hope you enjoy us for entertaining you, even on Christmas. We still provide you some entertainment. So yeah, Merry Christmas from all of us, the Army Men. And Merry Christmas from me too, guys. But that's not the last video for tonight, because I still gotta get the recap. So I'll see you later for that. And then that'll be it with the videos for today. So see you later.